strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
1470 AM and 95.3 FM, the Health and Wealth Radio Network. Listen for A Touch of Gray, the talk show for adults, with Carol Marks and Michael Harrison, Saturdays at 1. Talk 1470 is WWNN Pompano Beach and 95.3 FM W237BD Boca Raton, the Health and Wealth Radio Network.
You can become independently healthy, and I'll tell you how. Dr. Bob Martin here. If you want to feel, function, and perform the very best you can, please tune in and call into my show Sunday mornings at 10 on Talk 1470 WNN.
It's the question that makes kids and parents crazy, but the answer is a crucial part of your child's education. Have you done your homework today? I'm Andy Ford, president of the Florida Education Association. After a long day of school, it can be a challenge to motivate your child to complete homework, but homework is an essential part of learning. Here are a few ways you can help your child be successful. Set aside a place in your home where your child is comfortable doing homework. Pick a specific time to begin homework every day and stick to it. Make sure the TV is turned off so your child can concentrate on the work at hand. Review your child's homework and have consequences when it isn't done. Working together, parents and teachers can make this a successful school year for every student in Florida.
A message from the Florida Education Association. Great public schools are a basic right for every student.
Lupus. It's one of the cruelest, most mysterious diseases on earth. Lupus strikes without warning, can ravage any part of the body, and has no known cause and no known cure. Its health effects range from a skin rash to a heart attack. Lupus is an unpredictable and misunderstood disease that's difficult to diagnose, hard to live with, and a challenge to treat. Help us solve the cruel mystery. We're the Lupus Foundation of America, the only national force devoted to solving the mystery of lupus. We lead the fight to improve the quality of life for all people affected by this devastating disease. To learn more about lupus and how we can help those who suffer from its brutal impact, visit us online at lupus.org or call the Lupus Foundation of America at 1-800-558-0121. That's 1-800-558-0121.
So you see, son, good manners are very, very important. Someday, many years from now, when you're a grown-up, you'll be a man. And when you are, you should be a gentleman. Do you want me to go through it one more time?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open for ladies. If a door's shut, then knock first. Don't burp, don't swear, don't speak with your mouth full, don't reach across people's plates, keep your elbows off the table.
What table?
And don't interrupt. While we're at it, don't stare, don't use foul language, don't call people names, but do remember people's names. Always share your toys, play nice, and cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. On the bus, give up your seat to anyone who has trouble standing. Bottom line, treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But spending just 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush their teeth is easier and could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. For fun 2-minute videos to watch while brushing, visit 2min2x.org. That's 2min2x.org. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
Now you can get Talk 1470 WNN on 95.3 FM, too. Loud and clear, Health and Wealth Radio, WNN.
The opinions expressed in the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors. Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert co-hosts and guests, will tell you where to go. To play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Nobody,
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube, and tonight, like we always do, we're going to talk a little bit of golf. We're going to talk some travel, and in just a couple of minutes, we're going to be chatting with a couple of guests that we've got. First up is going to be a fellow by the name of Mike Brady, and he is the tournament and membership director at Winston Trails Golf Club, and he's got a tournament coming up, a charity event that he's going to want to tell us all about. Hopefully, you'll want to play in it and support a good cause. And then a little bit later on in the show, we will be chatting with Susan Buckley, and she is a author who just came out with a book called Eating with Peter, A Gastronomic Journey, and it was quite interesting to me as she had an opportunity to travel to different parts of the world with her husband, a critic who reviewed different restaurants and experienced the foods of different parts of the world, and she had an opportunity to write all about it, and we're going to find out more about that book, which is quite interesting, and there are recipes in the book, which I thought pretty cool, being the guy that likes to cook. And, of course, a little bit later on in the show, I've got some deals for you all to some far-off lands for some ridiculously cheap prices, so you're not going to want to miss any of that. But first, we always like to start the show off talking a little bit of golf, and, of course, this week is an incredibly important week in the golf world, being that it's the week of the first major on the PGA Tour. And it's obviously the Masters, which everybody looks forward to, well, all year long, but certainly in the beginning of the season being the first major and perhaps the best. And it's the first rite of spring, perhaps, getting a chance to watch the magnolias and the azalea and just the golf course that Augusta National is in all of its beauty. So lots going on. As always, it's difficult for me to talk too much about what's happening in the tournament, because for those of you who are listening live on Friday night to our broadcast here on WNN 1470 AM and 95.3 FM, you've got the advantage over those folks that like to tune in on Sunday from 6 to 7 on our sister station, WSBR 740 AM, 96.9 FM, and 103.9 FM. So we kind of have to dance around that a little bit. We don't want to ruin it for anybody. But there are some things we can talk about. And I don't know if any of you had an opportunity to watch on Wednesday. I was glued to the TV. Now, typically Wednesday, I do get invited to actually go every Wednesday, and I never go because it's just, I if I'm going to go, I want to watch the actual play on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday. And unfortunately, with all of you listeners out there, it still does not add up to enough to meet the criteria that Augusta National has for press credentials for the tournament itself. So one of these days I'll win tickets in the lottery and then I'll go on Wednesday and another day. But in the meantime, on Wednesday, what I do miss, besides the Golf Writers Association dinner, which is why I get invited, is the par three contest. And this year, the par three contest was a little bit different. It was something quite special. And it's always very, very cool, because the players that choose to play in it, they have an opportunity to involve their families, often having their kids caddy for them. And it's a lot of fun. But, of course, none of the players that are playing in the tournament want to win the par three, because nobody who has ever won the par three has ever gone on to win the tournament. So it's kind of like a jinx. So this year, fortunately, it was Tom Watson who ended up winning it, who was not playing in it, so we didn't have to worry about that jinx. But it was some of the other things that took place that were just very touching and unusual, perhaps. And for those of you who didn't get an opportunity to see, local superstar, Hall of Famer, perhaps best golfer ever, Jack Nicklaus, was playing in the par three event, and he had his grandson caddying for him. Gary Jr., I suppose it is, and the kid's 15 years old and he's caddying, and they asked him if he'd like to take a shot on one of these holes towards the end. I guess maybe it was the last hole. He hadn't taken a shot at all, and he gets up there and he takes a shot, and don't you know, he puts it in the hole for a hole in one. And just a perfect shot that he hit, and the reaction from the crowd, the reaction from the grouping, the reaction from his grandfather, Jack Nicklaus, was just priceless. I mean, Jack was in tears and asked how it ranks with all of his time that he spent at the Masters, all of his wins. He said that this was the number one best thing that has ever happened to him at Augusta, the opportunity to watch his grandson hit a hole in one. I mean, just the likelihood, the odds of this happening were just ridiculous. So it was just incredible, very, very touching. And then a little bit later on, Tony Finau, who was playing in his first Masters this year, he hits a hole in one with his, I'm assuming it was his mother and his kid there. And he got, you know, hit the same kind of shot that Jack's grandson hit. You know, just fed right down to the hole from way to the right of the hole with these crazy greens that Augusta has, even on the par three course. It was just crazy. And he got so excited, he takes off running down the fairway, turns around and turns his ankle and pops it out, totally dislocates the ankle and casually pops it back in himself. And, you know, I heard him being interviewed afterwards and he's saying, you know, going through his head, this is his first chance to play in the Masters, and it just can't go down this way where this celebration of this hole-in-one takes him out of the tournament. So on Thursday morning, he goes to get an MRI, and they confirm that nothing is broken. It was a dislocation that he popped back in, and obviously there was some pain involved. But he's determined to play in this Masters, and on Thursday, for a period of time, he had the lead at -3. I mean, it was just crazy. So he was still in contention. I'm not sure where he ended up finishing today, Friday, but he said he was going to ice it down, and he was determined to just stay in the moment and worry about each shot and not think about his injury or anything else, and just remarkable. So some crazy, crazy stuff going on at Augusta. I mean, it was just nutty. So obviously, the real story was, you know, Tiger and the strong field and who is it that's going to be up at the top of the leaderboard. And as of today, for those of you who plan on watching the replay later tonight, don't listen. I don't want to be a spoiler. But yesterday it was Jordan Spieth who was separating from the pack himself. Today it's Patrick Reed, who is the leader in the clubhouse at -9. And Spieth is at -4, so he's got a little bit of ground to make up. Mark Leishman's at -7. Rory is at -4. Henrik Stenson at -4. Tiger just barely made the cut, so he'll be going off early this weekend. And does he have a chance? Not likely. So way too many strokes to make up, so it's not going to happen. And it was kind of a surprise to me. It was a surprise to me that he's been playing as well as he's been playing. I never thought it would happen. And obviously with him playing as well as he's been playing and, you know, loving this golf course and performing so well when he was healthy, it's a bit of a surprise, I suppose, that he's not in contention. But you know what? There are so many great golfers that have a chance. It's still going to be a great tournament, and hopefully the viewership is not affected by the fact that Tiger is not going to be competing. Let's face it, Sergio Garcia, the defending champion, with the 13 that he posted on the par five yesterday, I guess this was, he's not going to be playing either. So he had his chance to celebrate. He had the champions dinner that he got to select the menu, and he came and he went. It's just not meant to be. Another thing that was really cool that I had a chance to watch earlier in the week, I don't know if any of you had an opportunity to watch it, was the drive, chip, and putt competition that the championships are held at Augusta. And watching these little kids compete at Augusta was just really, really cool, too. They did a great job with that. So that's golf's future. And, you know, kudos to Augusta. They've got some kooky rules and some strange things that they do, but they're warming up. I just saw that there's, I believe, going to be a women's tournament, that the final is going to be at Augusta now. So things that years ago that they would never have thought to do, they're doing now, and it's pretty cool. So I'm glad to see it. On another note for golf, I did want to mention, I've been mentioning it every week for the past couple of weeks, and that is a friend of the show who has been on in past years, and he does some good work. He's got a tournament coming up as well as the other one we're going to be talking about in a few minutes. But that's the Ralph Cochran Golf Classic. It's going to be taking place on Saturday, April 28th at the Mayaku Lakes Country Club in West Palm Beach. And what he's doing is he's raising money to build a second school in Jamaica through Food for the Poor. I believe his first school maybe was in Haiti. And this kid, he's literally just a kid. He's only 13 years old, but he's got a long career of giving back already. So it's pretty amazing. So if you'd like to find out more about it, you can go to foodforthepoor.org/RAFE, or you can give Latoya Boyan a call at 954-427-2222, extension 609. You're going to forget that. So just go to foodforthepoor.org/RAFE. And you can get more information about this wonderful tournament and the fundraising job that this young kid is doing, which is just remarkable. What we're going to do is in just a couple of minutes, we're going to be talking and learning about another great golf tournament that you could play in. And I always like to say that there's nothing better than going out and playing some golf in a tournament with a bunch of friends on a beautiful day, preferably a work day. But if it's a weekend, that's okay, too. And raising money for people in need. It's my favorite thing to do. And hopefully some of you will agree with me and take part as well. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break. We're going to have a message from our sponsor, and then we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. So stay tuned. And we are back. And if your business needs industrial workers, or if you're looking for work, you got to call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, or general labor positions, such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical, golf courses, and so much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and in Jupiter. So if you need legal insured workers, or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders toll free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749, or visit laborfinders.com.
I've been out there hacking every day of my life. Now I got the shorts and all the plaid sweaters. That new tailor-made driver didn't make me any better. Man, I hit them fat. Here we go. I hit them thin. Roll them in the bunkers. Man, I hit them again. I slice them in the bushes. Crank them in a tree. I pop that sucker up, I hook it out in the street. Yeah, I'm 245.
Right. And we are back, thanks to Toby Keith, with a little bit of inspiration for all of us hackers. And if you're a hacker, or if you're a good golfer, like I said a few seconds ago, nothing better than going out, playing in a tournament, raising some money for a good cause. And I like to let everybody know when those opportunities exist, because I love them myself. So without further ado, to find out about an important event that's coming up that you might want to join, we have the membership director and tournament director of Winston Trails Golf Club, none other than Mike Brady. Mike, are you there?
How y'all doing tonight?
I'm doing great. And yourself?
We're doing great. We're just working hard on this tournament, and it's really going to maybe one of the best I've ever done.
Well, I used to put on a lot of charity tournaments myself, and people who love to play in them, I don't know if they have any idea the amount of work that goes into it. So first of all, kudos to you for doing it and doing it for a good cause. So before we go any further, why don't you explain a little bit about what the event is and when it's going to be, and then we could talk some more details.
Okay, Brady's Heroes is a foundation my wife and I founded. You know, our son was an Army Ranger who was killed, and we try to put every year three different charities that we want to help, and one of them's always going to be related to soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
And so this year we have a Golden Spiral Yoga, which helps kids with cancer kind of cope with their cancer a little better, and it's out at Palms West Hospital in Wellington, Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Rodriguez Charities. It's an organization with children development and healthcare and veteran assistance, and he always helps a lot of soldiers too. And then the top one at the top of our sheet is Disabled American Veterans, and I always try to throw something a little different to make, you know, tournaments a little bit different. And this year it's $250 a person to play, $1,000 a team. But what I did was kind of go out a little bit, and I'm trying to get 53 active soldiers to play in this tournament out of the 144 golfers. So we put it out there on all of our emails and our websites that if we can get people to sponsor a soldier instead of asking them to do a whole team for $250, then we put their name next to that soldier and recognize them at the banquet. And this way, 53 active military soldiers get to play. And it's last 2 days we threw that out there, and we've gotten 15 people of the 53. So we're kind of looking for 38 more $250 sponsors for soldiers so it can be complete.
Well, that's
and
very
cool.
On the
cool. course that day, we have Bonefish Mac Grill here that has four different restaurants that they're going to do a Bloody Mary bar that morning for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have Outback's going to do steak and eggs for the breakfast. And we got great sports bags, golf shirts, golf balls, backpacks from the Army, good tumblers from the Army and Brady's. And it's really, really going to be a great event. And I got some celebrities, a few celebrities already playing. And in all your par three holes, you get an infinity on a hole. You get, I mean, it's just unbelievable stuff, you know.
Okay, so before we go any further, now that you've teased everybody, I think what we need to do is tell everybody where the event is and the date of the event so that they know that they're available and they can come play.
Okay, well, it's at Winston Trails Golf Club, which is in Lake Worth, mm-hmm. Jog Road. It's April 21st. It'll be 2 weeks from tomorrow morning, 8:30 shotgun, and the luncheon will be at 1 o'clock. And we have a renowned saxophonist, John Sax, is going to be playing the national anthem in front of all the soldiers 15 minutes prior to the shotgun. And if you want to, you know, get involved and sponsor a soldier or play, it's kind of going fast. But you can contact me, Mike Brady, 954-707-2287, or email me at mikebradyfl13@aol.com.
Okay. Now, Bonefish Max obviously is one of your sponsors, and I think you had mentioned that you were up there in the St. Lucie branch location,
yes.
which I'm very familiar with. I live up in that neck of the woods up in Palm City, so I'm familiar with it. So, first of all, thanks to them. But
okay, I'm going to let you talk to him. He's right here, Howard, and since you live up here.
Sure.
Good afternoon, Dan.
Hey, Howard. How are you?
Good.
So, first of all, how do you know Mike? How did you end up getting involved in this event?
Mike and I go way back. I'm a treasurer of the NFL for 20-some years.
Mm-hmm.
And we do our own tournament each year, and we always try to hold it at Mike's course. We just had our 40th annual, and over the years we've raised millions of dollars for children's charities. And Mike's always been helpful to us, so... I joined his group as well.
Well, first of all, you know, thanks to you, because obviously he's raising money for some wonderful causes. And these tournaments, I think people don't realize the competitive nature of golf tournaments in South Florida. There's lots of them, and everybody is always striving to be a little bit unique and have something better, whether it's better food or better fun and games or a really good golf course or whatever it is. So obviously it's sponsors like you that make tournaments like this successful. So thanks to that. And are you going to be playing in the event as well?
No, the groundskeepers are best.
well, that's good to know. So I sometimes I feel the same way. People think just because I'm in the golf media that I'm a pro golfer, and that's the furthest thing from the truth. So, but the bottom line is events like this, I'm assuming, I don't know if you know the answer to this, but I'm sure Mike does, that it's probably a scramble format, which makes it a lot easier for the folks that are not necessarily scratch golfers.
It's a scramble format. It does move things along, and it makes it much more enjoyable for those that aren't regulars on the course, and kind of makes it everybody can play.
Okay. Now, I'm assuming you're talking on Mike's cell phone. You're not coming through too well, so you may have to move to a better location or something. We're not.
I think he had a call running through, so I apologize, but it's off now.
Okay, good.
But yes, it is a scramble tournament.
Okay. And I'm assuming that there must be some fun games that are going to be out there. Well, first of all, I'd like to say that I'm glad to hear that there's a saxophonist as opposed to a bagpipe, because I've been to enough tournaments with the bagpipe,
right.
And, you know, I've had that. So this will be really cool. But what about some fun and games? I mean, is there going to be some events out there as well, putting tournaments, long drive events, something going on?
Yeah, Mike always has everything on the course. He's got hole-in-one contests, putting tournament.
Mm-hmm.
I think I heard him mention we got the Bloody Mary bar at the beginning. definitely a fun day around every place you go.
Well, okay. Unfortunately, the connection is not really good. I'm having a hard time hearing you, so we may have to depart a little bit sooner because it's just not coming through. So what I would like to do is just recap one last time so that everybody out there has a perfect opportunity to make it. We're talking about April 21st. It's Brady's Heroes. It's $250 per person, I guess, to play, or you could sponsor somebody in the military so that they can play. The event's at Winston Trails. The way to sign up is to reach out to Mike, and his phone number is 954-707-2287. So you can give him a call, and his email, I believe, was
MikeBradyFL13@AOL.com.
There you go. So, and of course, if anybody would like more information, they could always go to the show's Facebook page and they could reach out to me. If you, for whatever reason, you're driving in a car, you can't write this down. Facebook.com/The Golf and Travel Show. You could always message me. And of course, I have all this information written down, so I'll make sure that it gets out. And, once again, I just want to say thanks to all of you, to Mike, Howard, Thomas, I guess, is there as well, and the NFL alumni who's going to be involved, and all of the other folks that are sponsoring people in the military, because if it's not for these folks in the military that obviously put their life on the line so that we can have our freedom and go out and enjoy our lives, you guys are doing a great thing. So on behalf of the Golf and Travel Show, thanks for what you're all doing.
Thank you very much for putting this on. I hand you back to Mike.
Sure, thank you.
Yeah, I think what's really important is the fact that anybody out there, they can just put in their own sponsorship for themselves, and I'll put them with a soldier, or I'll put them with somebody else. And I do a couple other things that make it fun. I make it par as your friend, so that way it kind of moves everybody along.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're 65 and if you're 65 years and older, we put you up on the senior tee.
Nice.
That really makes it a lot nicer for people, too. And it's just a lot of a fun day, and any help we can get from everybody, we appreciate it. And we're just looking for 38 more soldier sponsorships. Or if they want to play, I'll put them with some soldiers, and they'd have a great time.
Well, and I have to say the other thing about this, too. I mean, I've done something similar as well. I've had soldiers that I've put into golf tournaments and stuff, and they are so appreciative. I mean, these are people who, like I said, they put their life on the line. It's not easy being a soldier. And when somebody can help them go out and relax and have a good time, and where people could just come up to them and say thank you for what you do, it's very important for them, and it's important for us. I mean, we feel good when we can give something back to the folks who, like I say, give it all for us. So, thanks again for what you do. And now that I have you on the phone, the connection's a little bit better. I don't know. He must have handed it to a spot where I can't.
Okay. But, what was great? I went to the Army office yesterday, and I walked in, and every soldier kind of stood up almost and saluted me because of what I'm doing for them. And, that just makes you feel good. And the fact is, I should be saluting them. You know what I'm saying?
Sure. No, absolutely. And I there are families that, all their kids go into the military. There's people that are predisposed to just doing more. And the rest of us who are not carrying that load and that burden, the least we could do is support them and help them play around a golf and be there to, just do the right thing by these folks that are always doing the right thing for us. So the people that applauded for you, I'm right there with them. I applaud you as well. And, again, not everybody could go on the front line and fight the battle, but there's other things that we could all do to show our support. And an event like this, playing an event like this, sponsoring somebody in the military so that they can play in an event like this, that's all a way that we can all do a little bit, a little effort for the cause. So it's important.
And you know what's so funny? Every time you have a tournament with soldiers, they're there before you get there. They get there like 4:30 in the morning out in their cars. They're so excited. And they're so used to getting up early. And it's amazing. You look out there and there's like 20-something cars, and you think, man, these guys do this every day for a living. They're up, they're up protecting us at that time of the day. And it makes you appreciate what you got.
Yeah, the vim and vigor that these guys have is incredible. Unfortunately, it makes me feel very inferior when I'm with people like that. But but again, they're a special breed. And it's just wonderful that they dedicate their lives for all of us. So it's great. So now that I have you and the phone connection is working, I'll let you one more time the details, the date, the place, the phone number, the email address, so that everybody knows it. Go ahead.
Okay, it's the date of the tournament. It's a four-person scramble, April 21st at 8:30 a.m. shotgun. Everybody's coming between 7 and 7:30 and register because you get a heck of a goodie bag. And we have a nice little breakfast for you. Go out. It's $250 per person, or if you want to sponsor a soldier, it's $250. And you can contact me, Mike Brady, at 954-707-2287, or my email at Mike Brady. It's MikeBradyFL13@AOL.com.